Jesus go and get you bride. Today is your wedding day. When we see the bridegroom on the clouds in the sky, will he be telling you hello or telling you?
Everybody that will, come help us sing in the choir tonight. Everybody that can, come help us sing in the choir.
And be ready to meet him face to face. We've got to fight a good fight. We've got to keep our faith.
Tomorrow will bring.
call our youth choir to come up here and help us sing tonight.
Who would have thought there was a mute button on this thing? I've got one. Sometimes I thought I had it muted on my little belt pack, and I could hear myself talking. I'm glad I wasn't one of them that said, I hope they didn't hear that. Don't you act like you ain't never done it. Are you glad to be in the house of God tonight? Not 45. Oh, you can do better than that. Give him praise. Not 45 of the Christian Unity Revival. Good news is we had three saved yesterday. One of the preachers here that was in them, just got a report there in the prayer room, that was here last night, was preaching, and he's reaching out as a part of this meeting. Had six saved last night. Amen. I'm telling you. And before we have prayer over the service tonight, I got to share this. It's so wonderful. How many of you don't know about these postcards? If you don't know, could you just raise your hand, whether you're in the choir? I ordered 5,000 of these. 5,000 that says the Christian Unity Revival, week 8. It's got the dates on there. And the church where it's being held here. It's got the little Facebook symbol. And it also says, follow us on Facebook, sponsored by Fellowship of Christian Athletes. And our target is youth in public schools. Okay? On the back of it, it's got the service times. And I'm telling you, it says below that, from pastors who care about you and your family. Down at the bottom, it's got the golden text of the Word of God, John 3:16. And today, around 3,500 of these went out in Clay County, Cherokee County, Towns County, and Union County. Isn't that wonderful? And you, and the great thing about it is this. And you look around and say, well, we don't see, the place ain't full tonight. Well, it's Monday. If you've been here for 7 weeks, you know how it operates, right? It grows. But I gotta tell this. There was a little boy here. Where's Isaac at? Where's Isaac? He's right. Here he is. This is Isaac. He's got on his Jerusalem Cruisers tonight. How many of these do you hand out today? 60, and I give him about 60 more. He gave a little boy in his class one of these cards, and the little boy said, Christian Unity Revival. He said, what's this? And he said, well, it's revival at our church. Now, how old are you? 11 years old. And he said, that little boy said, church. And said he held it, and he looked at it, and he said, I'm taking this home and giving it to my mama because I've never been to church in my life. Thank you, brother. There's you another one to give away. Isn't that amazing? Listen, there were kids that were just taking them right and left. And some of our retired coaches that coached was out, handing them out right and left all over. It is amazing. Allison, go good today? Two thumbs up right there, and I got her name right. Hallelujah. It's amazing at what God's doing. Matter of fact, in Union County said this, if you'll get them to us, we'll put them in their packets and mail them home to every one of them. That makes me want to shout. I've never in my life experienced passing out the gospel, for John 3:16 is the gospel. I've never experienced passing out 3,500 cards or more. I don't even know how many's left. If you got some extras, make sure you put them back at the sound booth tonight where we can get them out, because we're going to be sending the rest of them out to Union County because they had more students than anyone else. That just makes sense, right? Send them to where they're at. And not one person complained. That's a miracle, Brother Patrick. That is a miracle. In the day and age we're living in, that's a miracle. But after 7 weeks of revival and people carrying around a burden and weeping all over from the seats all the way in the balcony and around the front on the steps and the altars, when you weep and you get a burden like a Habakkuk had and you cry out to God and ask God to work a work in these days, let me tell you something. God works on our end, but He also works on the other end. He works on the other end. Hallelujah. Boy, I'm telling you, it's going to be easy preaching and singing tonight. Brother Patrick Odell, would you come and bless the service tonight? Praise God, my friend. I love him. He ain't been able to be here much because of work. Give him a hand as he comes to pray.
Father, Lord, as we bow, God, tonight in your presence, Father, we just feel so little before you tonight. God, we know that we're nothing, and Lord, we need you, God, to pass by this way one more time. Father, we're just inviting you and welcome you, Lord, in this place tonight. God, I pray that you'd just fill every avenue, Lord, that you'd speak to every heart. Father, I pray that you'd open our heart as you did that Lydia over there. Father, I pray if there be one tonight, Lord, that's never been saved, God, that you would speak to them tonight, Father, and draw them, God, to a place of repentance. I pray that you'd anoint this dear brother as he stands, God, to preach. Father, we pray for the singing, Lord, for the Parson family. God, we thank you for what you've been doing in this meeting, God. Lord, we know it's you. It's all you, Father. And we want to praise you tonight, Lord, for that. God, we thank you for saving us. Lord, I pray for this little child, God, that said he's never been to church before. Oh, God, I pray you'd get in that family, get in that home, Lord. God, I pray that they'd make it, Lord, to your house, God. Lord, that their lives would be changed, Father. Lord, I know what Jesus can do. Father, I thank you and I praise you. God, we magnify you tonight. Lord, we just ask you to have your way and help us tonight to be obedient to your spirit and your voice. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.
service like this when the power of the Holy Ghost is moving. Now listen, let me tell you something. Some of you were harlots and God saved you. Some of you were whoremongers and God saved you. Some of you were drunkards and God saved you. Some of you were homosexual, but God saved you. Some of you was a thief and a liar, but God saved you. Some of you just done things that you don't even want to mention, but God saved you. Choir, sing that verse 2 again right now. You ought to make some noise in the house of God tonight. Jesus came by.
I am free.
Took a wooden key and opened up the door at the cross. Hallelujah. Free tonight. Aren't you glad you've been free from drugs and alcohol? Aren't you glad you're free from sin? Come on now. Get on board tonight. Hallelujah. Don't be left behind. Sing it again, a cappella, one more time. Come on, the whole congregation, sing it. You know it.
It was told that he would come, and the race he would run, it would end on an old rugged cross. But when they laid him in the tomb, the power of the Lord went in the room. Now he reigns forevermore. He's coming back today to take us home, with him to stay where his glory forever will share. And when that first trumpet sounds, we will all be glory bound, where we'll live forevermore. Hallelujah.
Come to receive tonight's offering. I'm telling you, what a great place to be, amen. You can feel the power of God, can't you? Brother Michael, come on up here. I'm going to ask Brother Michael to pray for the offering. I asked him before service. I said, I'm not going to embarrass you or anything. He said, oh no. I didn't know this man till we went on the singing at sea. We didn't go together. We just met. And ever since we was on that boat for 5 days, worshiping the Lord, and then got back. And you've only missed one service, haven't you?
Two.
Well, you shouldn't have told me that. He's missed two services in 45 nights. I'm telling you, that's a blessing right there. And he's from over in Blairsville, Georgia. And I'm gonna ask him if he'll bless the offering tonight.
Lord, we thank you for this day. Lord, we thank you for all your many blessings. Lord, just take this offering tonight, Lord. Just use it for the uplifting of your kingdom, Lord. Lord, just bless each one that's here, Lord. Be with all the prayer requests, Lord. Anyone that's sick and afflicted, Lord. And God, most of all, be with the lost tonight, God. Lord, if there's one here that's lost tonight, God, let them come to know you before it's everlasting too late, God. We don't want to leave anybody behind when we go to heaven, God. We must just be with each one here tonight, Lord. We give you the honor and glory and praise for everything here. Amen.
Your neighbor tonight. Tell them it's good to be in the house of God. from Goshen, Indiana. Will you make welcome tonight the Parsons?
Second Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land.
I thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, for setting me free. I thank you, Lord, for my family. I thank you, Lord, for my family. I thank you, Lord, for saving me. I thank you, Lord, for setting me free. I thank you, Lord, for my family.
Come on, I gotta home, go home with her. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Bless you, Lord. Is it well with your soul tonight? Amen.
Thanks.
is there. Amen. We were back in the prayer room, and I told Brother Chris, after everybody started praying, I said, if this is all there was, just that prayer laying there tonight, I'd have been satisfied and we could have went home. I felt the Spirit of God like I hadn't felt Him in a very long time. I'd say we just go back to the prayer room. We've been watching you all for the last 7 weeks, and our heart, we prayed for you. We prayed for everybody that was here. Was I jealous? Just a little bit. Only because I said, just in our spirit, oh God, if we could just be there, we don't have to go sing. We just want to be part of what's going on. I love seeing the hand of God, and I love it that I know you guys, and that I know that it's real. I know that what's going on is real here tonight. I know your pastor, and I love him dearly, and I'm just so excited that the man has a vision, that he follows, that he listens to what God says to do. Amen. We are thrilled to be here. I don't know why we're here, but God knows. I know there's so many more talented that could take this stage, but I've come for one purpose tonight, and one purpose only, folks. Is to bless His holy name. He is worthy. Before the throne of God, even as we speak, night and day the angels cry, holy, holy, holy. So why in the world should I sit here silent when the angels are praising Him? One of these days, before His throne, I'm going to get my chance to praise Him. Angels, sit down. Oh, bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't miss your chance tonight to praise Him. Don't leave with regrets. Let's praise Him while we can.
What a sad time in heaven. Angels gathered stand to watch Jesus dying all alone. It broke their hearts to see the blood that He shed. They were all prepared to fly, but God turned to them and said, angels, sit down. Turn, just like she's saying, but the turn, I don't have to wait till my turn. I can start right now. Praise God. To sing a song, but God turns to them and says, angels, sit down, 'cause this is not your soul. See the smiles on their face, they've waited so long. They've been down to the fire. Children see.
stood in the courtroom, it touched her. gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken. They conquer death to bring me victory.
Celebrated yesterday. Now let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. You see, I know.
Just hold on, 'cause there's a brighter day.
Somehow my faith would say, just hold on.
'cause there's a brighter day. He never gave up. He never sand is on the shore, sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the seas, he's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. And he knows my name, every step that I take, every move that every tear that I cry. He knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain. I can't see the light of day, but I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my name.
Aren't you glad he knows your name tonight?
Lord, I don't know what tomorrow in store, 'cause I don't know a lot of things, and I don't have all the answers to the questions of mine. Oh, but I know in whom I have believed.
He knows my name, every step that I take, every move that cheer that I cry. He knows my name when I'm overwhelmed by the pain. I can't see the light of day, but I know I'll be just fine, 'cause he knows my
stone her, no one even cared.
But when he knelt down, they didn't stand a chance.
As they stood amazed as he knelt down, and with his fingers to the ground, he wrote a message of a different kind. Heads were hanging all around as their stones fell to the ground. Her sin was clear, but fault he did not find. Wrote a message of grace across the sands of time. I can see him hanging there, wooden cross and three rusty nails. It seemed that evil would at last prevail. Come and rescue God's only son. Would he heal himself and just walk away? This is not a price he should even have to pay. But they stood amazed as he laid down, and with his stripes and thorny crown, he rose. Of a different kind. Heads were hanging all around as his own blood poured to the ground.
He had no sin, he died for yours and mine. Wrote a message of grace across the sand.
Amen. How about it for the Parsons? Did you enjoy them? I don't know about you, but I'm glad they're back for tomorrow night, too. Praise the Lord. It is with delight that we stand here tonight. Welcome back our good friend, Dr. Steele. And would you make welcome tonight Dr. Tommy Steele as he comes to preach.
Are we on? Yeah. Good God, the mic might not have been on, but it's on up in him. Lord, have mercy. Great. God, I'll tell you. Woo, boy. I tell you what, God is doing something in this place. And I'm glad to be a part of what's going on up in here. That's it. My. Well, how many glad you're saved tonight? Say amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Woo. I told the preacher, I said, my brother, I said, them youngins grab a song like a dog grab a rag and just get all the juice out of it. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Good God. We're going to get into the word tonight because, man, I'm just telling you, with God is on the move, man. Lord, have mercy. Lord, glory to God. Thank God. I don't know where to even start. I can change my message 20 times. Every time I think I'm going one direction, I say, Lord, what do you want? But we're going to try this one. And I was just rejoicing today, preacher. I've got a lot of family on my daddy's side that I don't even know. And so they called me, had one die. They called me, 89 years of age, and said, look, it's your cousin. I know you don't know him. But we want you to meet some of your family. Would you come today? And so this morning, I went and they wanted me to speak. I took about 15, 20 minutes at the funeral. And I shared my heart, told them how to get, you know, that's a whole nother message. I better not get into that because I'd be like a fly in molasses. I'll get stuck and I'll never get out. But I preached on the subject. The way you see him now is not the way you're going to see him later. But to God be the glory. When the invitation was given, preacher, had 21 of my family members give their life to Jesus this morning. Hallelujah. Glory. Hey. Yes. God's good. Lord, have mercy. I want you to take your Bibles tonight and look with me to Luke chapter 13 and verse number 6. We'll start right there. And I'm going to roll it and I'll get the Lord, have mercy. They got me. I've been telling the folks, and they watching online. I've been telling everybody. I said, watch us live tonight. And they watching tonight. I told them, I said, now, the big part of that meeting and what you see when them singers and me preaching, I said, they got a room back there that's called the prayer room. I said, when you come out of that prayer room, I said, you got 50, 60 men back there calling on God, got all these ladies praying. I tell you, when I come out of that prayer room, I feel like it was in Acts chapter number 3, Acts 2, when they come out and they said, they must be drunk. They said, oh, no, this ain't the third hour. You suppose this is that, which is spoken by John. That's the Holy Ghost. Yeah. But look at Luke chapter number 13, verse 6. The Bible said he spake up also this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came and saw fruit thereon and found none. Then said he unto the dresser of his vineyard, behold, these 3 years I come seeking fruit on this fig tree, and I find none. Cut it down, why cumble it to the ground? And he answered, said unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also, till I shall dig about it and dung it. And if it bear fruit, well, if not, then thou shalt cut it down. Look at verse number 8, which is my text. He answered, said unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also, till I shall dig about it and dung it. I want to speak tonight on this subject. I'm glad God gave me another chance. I'm glad God, Lord, brother, I told Matt, I said, it's amazing. They up here singing this song. I said, he are hooked up with God, and so have I. I said, they singing about God, and then God said, put on my heart to speak on this subject. Let's pray together. Father, I want to thank you and praise you and give you glory. You're such a wonderful God and a great Savior, and you're absolutely amazing. I thank you for the man of God, Pastor Chris. I thank you for First Lady of this wonderful house. I thank you for the family of God that's here tonight. I praise your name for your visitation, and God, your presence is here tonight. Drive the demons of hell back. Walk over this place and throw your weight around. Show the devil he got some power, but you got all power. And he's just a creature, and you are the creator. Lord, I realize every day I live that you don't have to have me, but I sure got to have you. Has anybody stepped up in this place lost? Bring them under conviction. Save them by the grace of God. And maybe somebody being backslid on you. God, bring them home tonight. And everything you do, we'll praise him, thank him, and give you glory. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Glory to God. You can be seated. Woo! Glory to God. I'm going to try to get it to you tonight. But I'm telling you right now, I feel... Take it easy, boy. Hey, you see, I got a four-wheel drive that's pushing me. Said I got a Father, Son, Holy Ghost, and blood. All that's pushing me. I got a four-wheel drive. Somebody said they don't understand how that a black cow can eat green grass and give out white milk. I tell you something better than that. I don't see how God take a cold-hearted sinner and dip him in red blood and it come out white as snow. But I know it works. Somebody help me in the house. Oh, listen to me tonight. Let me get this to you best I can. I know on each one of us, look around us. All we see is a mess. There's a mess in our nation. There's a mess in our society. There's a mess in our communities. There's a mess in our families. Yes, there's even a mess down at the house of God. But there's something I want you to notice tonight. I'm going to give you three things tonight, and I'll be out your way. I want you to notice, number one, that God loves to take messes and make miracles. Oh, yes, there's a mess, but God loves to take a mess and make a miracle. I said God loves to take a mess and make a miracle. Am I right about it? How many miracles in this house used to be a mess? Say amen right there. I want you to hold your place and come with me to 2 Timothy chapter number 4 and verse number 6. Come to 2 Timothy 4 and verse number 6. Let me show you something here. Now, Paul the apostle, you know the story, has got his head on a chopping block, and they're about to take, Paul is about to see the light of day. He's about to check out of here and wind up in glory. Well, you know, whenever you got, when most of the time when somebody died, you always say they had some last words. They said this before they checked out. Well, let's see what Paul had to say before he checked out. 2 Timothy 4, and notice verse number 6. Paul, now you got to picture this, my brother. There's a Roman soldier got Paul's head on a chopping block. And he said, you got anything you want to say before I take your head off? Well, Paul looked up in his face. And this is what Paul said. He said, I'm now ready. Hey, God Almighty, you got to be ready to say something like that when your head is about to come off. I'm now ready. And then he said, I'm ready to be offered. And the time of my departure is at hand. I've fought a good fight. I've kept the faith. I've finished my course. I've kept the faith. And henceforth, there's laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, not only me, but unto all them that love his appearing. Now, Paul said, don't miss this class. Paul said, for you look at what I did and say glory. He said, I want you to back up and see my story. There's a whole lot of people see the glory, but they don't know your story. I said, there's a lot of people see the glory in your life, but they don't know your story. Because you don't look like what you've been through. You don't look like where you came from. Am I right about it? So let's back up. Look at his story. Look in 1 Timothy chapter 1 and notice verse 12. 1 Timothy 1 and notice verse 12. Watch this. He said, for you brag about and give me glory about what happened. He said, let me say this to you. You better back up. Let me tell you a little bit about my story. Look at 1 Timothy 1 and verse 12. He said, I thank Christ Jesus our Lord, who have enabled me, for he counted me faithful, putting me into the ministry, who was before a blasphemer, a persecutor, an injurious, I obtained mercy because I did it ignorantly in unbelief. And the grace of our Lord Jesus, our Lord was exceeding abundant with faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. This is a faithful saying and word of all expectation. And expectation means you need to listen to this, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I'm chief. Paul said, look, you don't know, understand where I come from. He said, before you look at me and tell me how good I am, he said, look at Jesus and tell God how good he is. Oh, somebody in the house, good God, hey. My brother, Before you let that house that you live in and that car that you drive and them clothes that you wear and that place that you stay and that money in your pocket make you feel like you're better than somebody else, you better back up and realize what Paul said in 1 Corinthians 15:10. How he said, by the grace of God, I am what I am. We ain't better than nobody else. That's got to, hey, am I right about a church? Now come in. Now come in. I want to show you something. Number two, the second thing I want you to see, that God takes messes and make miracles. Now we're going somewhere. But number two, don't give up on nobody. Look back at our text in Luke chapter 13. Now, in Luke chapter 13, the Bible said in verse 6, he spake this parable. A certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard, and he came and saw fruit thereon and found none. And notice of this, whoever this is, which I believe was God the Father. I believe it's the Father's vineyard. I believe Jesus was the dresser. He said, why? Because when you read Isaiah chapter 5, verse 1 through 7, God talks about his vineyard. Had some figs in his vineyards and bitter figs. And it ties in to Luke chapter 13 and verse number 6. And so what happened was, he said, listen, he walked up to it. And he's the dresser. He looked at it, and a certain man had a fig tree planted in his vineyard. And he came and saw figs thereon, and found none. Then he said unto the dresser of the vineyard, behold, at these 3 years I come seeking fruit on this fig tree and find none. Cut it down. Why cumble it to the ground? Now here's what he said. Now, the father got out and he looked at the dresser. He said, I want you to chop down this tree. He said, I want you to know something. He said, I have been looking for fruit on this tree now for 3 years. And he said, every time I walk by, it hadn't produced no fruit. He said, let's just chop it down, let it fall to the ground. But oh, good God Almighty, hey. You don't know how many times that the enemy has talked to Father about you. And he's just like he did Job. Know how the devil talked to God about Job? Hey, you don't know, he's an accuser of the brethren. And what he's done has went to God. And you don't know how many times he said, God, and you ought to chop them down. They said, yes, here. Yes, Father. They said they was going to do this. They said they were going to do them. Start a van route. They said they're going to pay their tithe. They said they're going to get saved. They said they're going to be faithful. They said they're going to be a worker. They said they're going to get in the choir. They said they're going to teach a class. They said they're going to preach the gospel. But God, they ain't done nothing yet. Cut her down. And the Father, the Father, come here, Matt. The Father said, why don't you just go ahead? The devil said, you ought to cut him down. Cut him down. Come here on this side. Hold this axe. He said, you ought to cut him down. But come here, boy. You ain't ready yet. Come here. Yes. But what you don't know, every time the Father, the devil tried to get the Father to cut you off and to cut you down, I boy, listen, thank God in the courtroom walks a lawyer. His name is Jesus. Hey. Hey, bro. Confession is good for the soul. Now, I have to be honest. There's been times I've had a speeding ticket. I've had one. And I hate going to no courthouse. So what I done, I called up a lawyer. And I said, look, can you handle this for me? And I never showed up at the court. When my name was called, he was right there. Said, still, I got him. I go, come on now. I ain't the only one. Watch this now. For here's my point. I didn't show up. Father, the Father, hold that axe back like you're going to chop it down. What you don't know is every time the devil has tried to get God to cut you down, because some of you told God, I'll teach a class last year. I'll get in the choir last year. I'll be a soul winner last year. I'll drive a van last year. I'll pay my tithe last year. I'll be faithful last year. I witnessed last year. Oh, he said, chop them down. But you don't know how many times Jesus said, no, Father, no, let me have them. God, don't chop them down. Let me have them. Let me work with them. God, let me have them. No, God, and he just walked all around you and said, God, not this time. God, no, I don't want you to chop them down. Let me have another year with them. Let me, I know what they said last year. Let me have them one more time. Let me hold them one more time. Oh, somebody up in the house ought to give God praise that God has gave us another chance. Somebody help in the house. So when you see blind Bartimaeus in Mark 10:46 sitting beside the road begging, or the woman at the well that got that living water, that had the five husbands. When you see that maniac in Mark 5 that nobody could bind and chain, that little old boy that's sitting on his mama lap named Tommy Steele, and his neighbor told that she never amount to anything, that she never be anything, that she never do nothing in life. When you see that little boy that's sitting on his mama's lap and listen, and then you want to chop him down, I'm glad, bless God, I got a Savior that don't see like a man. Oh, somebody in here ought to give God some praise. Hey, I got a Savior. When everybody else gave up on you, when folks kick you to the curb, when folks kick you out, I got a Savior. They said, no, don't chop him down. Oh, God, give me a chance with him. Let me have him, Lord. Oh, let me work on him. Watch this. You can put your axe down. Watch this. I know some of you been in prison. I know some of us been divorced. I know some of us have come from drugs. But don't count us out, because I don't give up on nobody. I know right now you got family members and loved ones that, I mean, they've been on the streets for so long. And boy, God, the devil said, chop them down. But ain't you glad? And my last point is this. I will tell you, you ought to thank God that God has given us another chance. I say you ought to praise God that God has given us another chance. Come in. I'm about to bring it home to you now. Watch this. The Lord said, he said in verse 8, he answered and said unto him, Lord, let it alone this year also until I shall dig about it and dung it. He said, Lord, they got a bunch of stuff in them. He said, let me dig. Let me dig about it. See, that's some stuff that you had in your life. God said, let me get this out. And that's why they can't sing. And let me get this out. And that's why they can't preach. And let me get this out. And that's why they can't get their mind right. And let me take this out. Let me get this out. Oh, God said, he said, let me dig about it. He said, let me dig. And then, sus, he said, let me dung it. Now, let me put it where you can get it. When a baby makes a deposit in his diaper, we say, that baby, somebody better change this baby. You're messed in his clothes. You call it mess. Have you ever rolled past a field out in the country and a farmer has been planting stuff? And you say, whoa, whoa, boy, it smells out through here. He undung this whole field. Why he put all that dung all over his field? I'll tell you why. Because it ain't long. Here come a mater. Here come a squash. Here come a cucumber. Here come a cantaloupe. Here come a watermelon. Here comes some corn. Why? Because that farmer took mess and made a miracle out of mess. But I want you to understand tonight that God sent me to tell you, hey, don't give up on nobody. You ought to thank God, because God knows how to make a miracle out of a mess. I said somebody ought to give God praise, because God knows how to make a miracle out of a mess. Somebody help me up in here. See, this is the way the average church member Baptist walk around. They're going to cut down everything and chop people up. But Jesus don't walk around with no axe. He walks around with a shovel. he digs stuff out. He clean that up. He clean that out. He'll clean this up. He'll clean that out. Oh. And then all that stuff, all that dung that's ever come your way, and people don't know it, and they counting you out. Yeah, look at them now. The Lord said, no, yeah, just leave them alone. Y'all going about your business. Let me have them. Give me another chance with them. Let me work on them for a little bit. Let me. Good God. Come here, bro. Yeah, come here for a minute. Either one of you, don't matter. But come here, I'm going to show you something. See, here's what God will do. Yes. See, here's what God said. Look, when everybody else gives up on you, God said, look, I know you've been in the dirt, but let me clean you up a little bit. Clean your eyes and yeah, let me wash you.
Yeah.
Yes. Let me just let me clean them feet out so you can walk right. Let me clean them hands up. Let me clean you up. Let me clean you up. Anybody up in this house know what I'm talking about? Anybody up in this house know what I'm talking about? Oh, somebody ought to give God glory that he haven't given up on you. You ought to thank God he gave you another chance. Amen. Yes, I'm glad. Brother, as many times as I messed up, as many times as I failed, and I've looked at the Father, and I've said a many a time, he need to go ahead and chop me down. I said, I'm so unworthy. And your Father said, and Jesus said, Father, can I use this on him? Let me put a little dung in there. Yes. Whoa. Let me put a little mess on him. I'm going to make a miracle out of all this mess. Look, some of you sitting here this morning, tonight, and I'm done. I'm gonna quit. I ain't really done, but I'm gonna quit. But some of you sitting here right now, you know what I'm talking about. I'm telling you right now, when God Almighty found you, just like he did me, I was nothing but an absolute mess. Oh, but I'm glad that Jesus came by whenever and had his shovel in his hand. And he said, boy, do you realize you're a mess? I said, yes, sir. He said, boy, let me work on you a little bit. And I said, what you gonna do? He said, let me work on you. See, because when he found me, I was way down in the miry clay. I was way in a horrible pit. And he come down to me. I couldn't get to him, so he came to me, came down where I was, and he got me. Yes, and he picked me up when everybody else gave up on me. They picked me up, and God said, come on, I'm going to take you up here and put you on another level. And God put me up, and then he said, let me just kiss on you for a while. And he turned me all the way around. You see, hey, brother, Revelation 1:5 said this. It said, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful and the first begotten of the dead, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. See, he didn't do like some of you would do or I would do. Look at that verse. He said, from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins. He didn't wash us and then love us. If one of your children fall in some mud, you'll say, hey, you better get back. You better get back. Let mama clean you up. Don't you put your dirty hands on me. God said, no, that ain't how I done it. I want you to put your dirty hands on me.